Hi, I'm Menno Marks. I'm a developer advocate on the Google Maps API team. With me today is Steve Gray.
Hi there.
Steve is a Google developer expert. Steve, tell us a little bit about the Google Developer Expert program.
Google developer experts are really experts that Google have recognized as an expert in certain product fields. So for me, it's maps. And we go to conferences, we talk at events, we build sample code and blog posts about how to use different products. You could really say that we're the go-to gurus for the different products.
Yeah. So you've built an app using the iOS SDK for Google Maps, and it's called Synoptic. Tell us a little bit about it.
So Synoptic pulls down data from the UK Met Office.
The Met Office? Sorry, I don't know what that...
So the Met Office is a government body here in the UK that deal with all things weather related. So forecasts, they build models for how what's happening in the weather on the island, and give the data out as forms of forecasts on the TV and data out as developers.
Okay, great. So the app we have running here, why don't we go ahead and take a little bit of a look at it so that people can see what we're talking about. So what am I looking at right now?
This is the precipitation forecast for the UK for the next few hours. And as you see, the layers are animating across the map, and you have bands of rain that are coming across the UK. More yellow and the more red the actual color is on the overlay, the more rain that's in that area.
Right, okay. So this is the kind of thing that you would see in, you know, in a TV broadcast at night or something like that, and telling you about what's going on there. Okay. So how did you do this animation?
So when the app starts, when the view is loaded, it pulls down the latest forecasts and the latest observations for the UK, and then lines up the images as an animation and then loops around them on the map. And so you can see this really nice flow of data across flow of images across the map.
Okay, and you're using ground overlays, and you're basically just changing the PNG that the ground overlay uses.
Yeah, that's right. I basically go away and fetch up all the layers of all the images in the animation, and when that's preloaded, then just start the animation off. And for every loop around the timer, it will insert the ground overlay onto the map, and it gives us nice illusion of animation.
Cool. So, what are some of your favorite overlays that you've got here?
So so there's two really awesome overlays here. My favorite is you've got the cloud and the rain together, and as we fetch the images.
So it does take a moment to fetch the images, but once it does it, they're cached, right? So
exactly.
They can run through that. And you can see that's actually pretty fast.
Yeah. So yeah, it'll go away and fetch all the images so that we don't have this broken cycle of animation. We've got one infinite loop of the animation of the latest forecast. So you have here the cloud cover and the rain cover of the UK forecast for the next few hours.
You can barely see the UK.
Yeah, exactly. This is natural for the UK. Yeah. We're always under clouds. It's a given.
I've noticed that since I've been there.
So we have this layer, which is really nice, because every time you load this up, it will load up the forecast for the next 8 to 12 hours. And my other favorite is these observation layers. And you have this infrared observation. And this is a really nice overlay, because it's actually the images that come from the weather satellites that are looking down on all the time.
That's really cool.
So it's the unprocessed images that you don't really get to see on the weather reports. And as you see, you have this kind of inverted look where you can see the cloud cover coming across. Again, you can't really see the UK, but eventually when you run the code in different days, obviously it's live data, so we're covered in clouds all day, but you can see the overlay of the UK, and it's a really good indicator of whether you've actually put the ground overlay on the map correctly, whether it all lines up to the bounding boxes.
So this is an interesting one. If you take a look at the rainfall one, you can actually see that underneath the animated overlays, you actually have is it a custom map or is it a tile overlay?
It's a tile overlay that I've created myself. It just allows us to have this, when we're putting the ground overlays of the actual visualization on top of it, it just allows the data to sync and allows us to remove the labels for the places, because we don't really want to see the labels and on the map.
Right, so just get them a nice clean background there. Yeah, okay, cool. And again, this is an open source project, right?
Yep.
So it's up on GitHub.
Yep.
Here's the link for that. And if you have if you want to explore the Google Maps SDK for iOS, here's the link for that. And specifically, if you want to look at the ground overlay documentation, you can look here. All right. Well, thanks for coming in, Steve.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
Pleasure. And thanks for listening. Bye.